Hello, my name is Abhishek Gaurai, a Google Summer of Code 20 student working under Digital Impact Alliance at Event Foundation Organization and under Mozilla Global as the umbrella organization. So my project was to develop Flint JSON User Interface, which is a platform-independent desktop app built on Electron and React, which is mainly used to create projects from predefined packages or JSON files, or to create config files, which mainly points to a set of JSON files, which is used to drive Flint, or to create JSON files from a scratch-based editor or a form-like editor, which I will show you in the next part of the video. So let's see the working version of the app. Okay, so it's launched right now, and I will show you the first feature to create a project from a predefined package. So a package may be similar to standard JCBM JSON project, which contains all these files. And now we would like to choose a particular path. Oh, here it says that I have not chosen any particular project, so let us choose a project. I will choose the standard JCBM JSON and then choose the path. Okay, I will create it in desktop. Okay, and click next. So here it says, are you sure you want to create standard JCBM JSON? Yeah, I am sure. Yes, the project has been created. Okay, so here it says if you want to open the project or not. So it gives the feature to the user that if you want to open the project right after creation. So I will go for yes. Yeah, so here we are given two options, that if we want to choose the scratch JSON editor, then okay, let's see in action. Yeah, so here it is, the scratch JSON editor. So here you can edit any particular file and then click on transform to get the glimpse of the editor, what you have changed or what not. So I will change it here and let's see if it changes or not. So this file, so these parts have changed. Yeah, it's changed. So let's save it. Yeah, it saved successfully. Okay, let's now go back to home, create another project. Okay, next. Yeah, I want to create it. Okay, do you want to open that? No, I don't want to open. Let's move forward. Okay, let's now create a JSON file from scratch. I have chosen the format. Yeah, scratch JSON editor. Okay, create CFG file. Okay, let's choose some files which the config files should point to. Yeah, I have chosen all these files. And yeah, let's choose a path, a desktop. I will save the file in desktop. So this should be a file gcbmconfig.cfg present in the desktop. Let's click next. Yeah, my CFG file is created. Let's see. Yeah, it's created and let's open it. Yeah, there are three files which I had chosen earlier, the standard gcbm internal variables, the pools and the local domain. So yeah, it's chosen. Let's now do another thing. Let's create all these files, like the template files, with the config file. So I will switch this on and the project name. So let's name it as custom and let's choose the path. It's okay, let's save it in desktop. So it will be saved in desktop/custom and click next. Yeah, my CFG file has been created and I will hope that the project is also created. Let's move to custom. Yeah, there are files. Okay, let's now open a project which I had earlier opened. Yeah, let's open standard JCBM JSON. Here all the files are selected automatically. Now if you want to delete a particular file, like if I want to remove spinup.json, I've removed it, click next. And I would like to load the template editor. Let's see what it is. So see, the internal variables doesn't have a particular template, so it's automatically loaded in the scratch JSON editor. But the local domain has a template, that's great. So we can see all these things, like it can be changed. The date picker is here. Okay, let's save it. So like the save button is here for your disposal. For the modules, let's change something. Yeah, it's automatically changing here. That's great part. I click Ctrl S. So an accelerator is also registered for the save function. Okay, let's move to the next feature, the open files. Here what you can do is you can select all the files explicitly and then open the file template editor. Yeah, I can change anything. You can save it. The tabs can be switched from one place to another. You can close a tab. You can add a new tab also. Let's see. Provider config is loaded. It doesn't have a proper template, so it's loaded in a new JSON file in the Scratch JSON editor. So yeah, that's all for the demonstration. So it's an Electron app. So it's packaged for all possible platforms like Windows, the Debian based operating systems like Ubuntu, like Fedora, and also for macOS. Like it's a DMG file, you can unzip it and put it into applications, and a zip file which provides an app file which you can execute. So you can go to the releases in the repository page. Yeah, and the dev file is for Debian based systems, RPM is for Fedora based systems or Fedora itself, .exe file is for Windows, and .zip is for Mac, and .dmg is also for Mac. So yeah, so I would highly recommend you to use the app, and if you face any particular issues or bugs, please raise an issue and we'd love to resolve it.